Okay, it's the weekend again, so it's very quiet here in the shop. You can hear the lights buzzing. But we have a rare occurrence here. We have an aircraft engine, but we also have a historically significant aircraft engine. We've got an Orenda Type 14 turbojet engine here, built in Canada. And this engine actually comes out of a Canadair Sabre 6, which is a license-built copy of the F-86. Now, the J-47 we recently had in here also goes into an F-86, so this would be the Canadian competition for the General Electric J-47. But this engine was primarily designed to be put into an all-weather interceptor of Canadian design in the 50s, actually in the late 40s, and it's right up there. That's a picture we've got on our wall of a couple of CF-100s in flight. So yes, it's an Orenda turbojet from the CF-100, not the Avro Arrow. You can see it's got the individual combustors, the combustor cans. There's six of them. It was designed in the 40s, and so it doesn't have a lot of the features of the modern fighter jet engines, but it is nonetheless out of a frontline fighter jet of the Korean War era. Now we're in the process of taking off the fuel control, which is up here, fuel pumps and fuel control. This is the fuel control. These are the fuel pumps up there. There's a fuel filter we've taken the element out of there. The oil filter we've taken out. This is the control linkage linked to the pilot's throttle. And those strange looking things, those are ejectors which use vent air to draw the air out of this chamber, the forward of the firewall in the nacelle. They help to ventilate and circulate the air, draw the hot air out of the forward compartment. Let's just take a quick walk around. We'll look inside there in a second. This turbojet has no variable stators and no bleed valves, and so it's a very simple design. And it doesn't quite have the efficiency or the flexibility of the more modern engines. There's a turbine case right here. Got an insulating blanket over the tail cone. And in here, it's kind of dark, but that's the exhaust cone. Okay, so right here is where the electric starter attaches to the engine. It weighs about 100 pounds. This is one of the largest engines that uses an electric starter. So we're going to put a drive spline in there. We're going to turn the engine over. And this engine is going to allow us to illustrate one thing. Inside this engine, inside this case right here, there is a bevel drive gear. A 90 degree drive, and inside this strut there's a what they call a radial drive shaft, and what it does is it takes power from the engine, from the center rotating shaft of the engine, and takes that power out to the outer cases so it can be used to drive other accessories. And I'll show you that right now. There's the number one strut. There's a radial drive shaft inside there. And right up there, this is the outer angle drive, which changes the radial drive shaft's rotation to an axial rotation outside the engine. And what I'm going to do is I'll move a bit closer. The vertical shaft there is the radial drive shaft, and the gear face we're looking at straight on, that's this shaft here, which drives the fuel pumps, which are on top of the engine. Okay, I'm turning the engine now, and if you can see that drive pad turning, that square drive, that's the tachometer generator, which gives an indication of how fast the engine's turning. So all modern engines have a version of an angle drive from the core engine or the high pressure system, a radial drive shaft, and another gearbox. This would be called the auxiliary gearbox. No, this would be called the transfer gearbox. This is the auxiliary gearbox, transfer gearbox, and then the main drive with all the other accessories is called the accessory gearbox. Now, this being a single spool turbojet, the drive is off the main shaft. Now, if this was a larger, more modern turbofan engine, there would be another system with the fan and the low pressure system. That is not what the accessories are driven off of, because the fuel control and the fuel and the burners or combustors and fuel nozzles run the core engine. The low pressure system is outside the core engine, and its speed varies a lot depending on the atmospheric conditions. So the core engine is always what drives the radial drive shaft and all the accessories. The accessories are oil pumps, fuel pumps, tachometers, electrical generators. That's all I can think of right now. And the starter. The starter is always connected to the core engine, not the low pressure system. This is a single spool turbojet, so the whole thing would be considered in modern language to be a core engine. There is no low pressure system. Now, we've taken off the cover to this gearbox, this little transfer gearbox here, to illustrate the inner workings. This is what was on there originally. Actually, this is incorrect. This is an industrial gearbox cover. The one that should be on here and the one that will be going on there is this one. I like that one better, don't you? This is an aircraft gearbox cover. This is an industrial. I don't know why the industrial one doesn't get the emblem, but there you go. You like that one better? Or how about that one? Okay, after a couple of hours of fiddling and removing and removing and removing, there's a lot of stuff in this engine. We've removed the fuel control. You see, there's the drive shaft, the longitudinal drive shaft. We've got some drive pads there that weren't used, but they were connected to the fuel pumps. There's the two fuel pumps. This is where the tach generator was. And these are all the connections we had to undo. Rigid lines make it so much more fun. It's very, very difficult to get them all to work and be happy at the same time. And there's our engine. These red straps are in place because those are to help reroute the electrical leads to the electric starter when we rebuild this thing. But we should be able to turn the engine over and see how much resistance the accessories caused, because now there's nothing connected to the auxiliary drive. Okay, let's give this thing a spin and see if there's any difference from the last time. You can see the transfer gearbox here is working, but there's no load now, there's no drag. There's the main bearings on the shaft, and no accessories are being driven by the power takeoff, so it'll go for a while. You really need to resist the urge to stick your fingers in there, because the rotor is the compressor and the turbine all together, probably close to 1,000 pounds, and if you stick your finger in there, it'll be like a carrot slicer, chop, 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 chop. So don't do that. It's not just a fan. It's a great big heavy piece of machinery. Once more. And now, for you disbelievers, I'm going to show you the mysterious radial drive shaft. We've taken the bolts out of the transfer gearbox. It's just an angle drive, very simple. A couple of bevel gears. Let me put this on the table. Okay. And now, I'll put this back in. Let's give the engine I'll put the hand crank tool back in, give the engine a little bit of a turn. Can you see that? Can you see that turning? I'm gonna pull it out now. There you go. That's what transmits all the power from the jet engine to the fuel pumps, generator, tachometer, and oil pump. That's your radial drive shaft. This one's in very good condition, very little wear, which is good because it'll be a very rare and expensive part. Okay, one more shot. We're gonna try to shoot down through the strut, and I'll show you the other angle drive spline coming off the main shaft, which drives the radial drive shaft. We're gonna try to show that. Hang on. Okay, with the help of a flashlight, look at that, there it is. That's about 18 inches down, well, 15. And that's the output of the angle drive on the front main bearing, the number one bearing. That's how your jet engine drives the accessories. I think those are just cool, don't you? Fume ejectors. And let's see if we can get a look at the turbine while it's coasting down. All the way around here. Got the flashlight. There we go. There's the exhaust cone. Sorry about the lack of lighting. So we've begun disassembly of the Orenda Type 14 turbojet by removing the fuel system, or the fuel pumps anyway. It's going to be a lot of work. I hope to make quite a few videos of this thing. This was the Canadian engine for the Canadian license-built copy of the F-86 Sabre, which was called the Canadair Sabre 6. It's a competition for the J47. The J47 is a lighter engine, produces about 5,500 pounds of thrust in the Sabre. And this engine produces about 6,500 pounds of thrust, but it is heavier. So who's to say which one's better? But I think it's a real privilege to be able to work on both of them in this little shop in the Canadian North. So thanks for watching and stay tuned.